Bonjour Gary, c'est un immense plaisir de vous recevoir pour cette première édition des Pinball Blasters. Pour ceux qui ne vous connaissent pas, vous êtes le mythique fondateur de sternpinball et vous arrivez tout droit de Chicago, d'où ma première question. Est-ce que vous avez fait un bon voyage?
Yes, of course I had a good trip. And plus that I get to come to France. I love France. I get to come to a really exciting new pinball event here at Avranches. And so everything's wonderful.
Quelles étaient vos ambitions quand vous avez créé Stern Pinball?
There were two things that we wanted to do. First is I needed a job. And I make pinball machines, so there wasn't much else to do but to create a pinball company. But the other is that, like many of the people who work at Stern, it's a job, it's a vocation, it's an avocation. We really, pinball, the world would continue without pinball, but a little bit of the fabric of life would be gone. So we want to continue pinball and grow pinball. And now we are really seeing a great growth in, I'm not even going to say a resurgence, a growth in pinball. And this is what we wanted to do. We think it's, you know, it's a good social game. It's a ball and bat game. It's a fun game. And we want to make fun. So the two reasons for Stern Pinball is I needed to work, or I wanted to work, and the second is that we really want to create, grow, and preserve this fun game we call pinball, or you call flipper.
Il y a 20 ans, on donnait le flipper pour mort. Vous étiez le seul survivant d'un âge d'or. Vous avez réussi à faire perdurer notre hobby, même dans cette période très compliquée. Vous êtes donc resté la seule marque historique encore en vie après toutes ces années. Comment expliquez-vous cela?
We had to. We were tenacious. There were many up and down periods in pinball. Right now, we're what I think is a continuing up period. I believe it will continue because of what we're doing with pinball. But going back 20 years ago, we knew that our other that our then competitors had left or would be leaving pinball, and we dedicated ourselves to continuing it. We saw an opportunity when the other companies were leaving. As an example, Williams, which my father had owned once, and I started in the stockroom working at Williams when I was age 16. Williams was a great company, but it was no longer, as a big public company, going to concentrate on pinball. It had other businesses it wanted to go into, gambling businesses and home video game businesses. It wasn't right for them, but it was right for us, and we were the right ones for pinball. We were the right ones that could be big enough and invest in it, and we have invested a lot, and we are continuing to invest, especially with Insider Connected. And so for us, it was the right thing to do. But tenacious, have to stick to it. And there's been other times that business has been difficult. We don't give up.
À Pinball Mag, nous évoquons souvent un nouvel âge d'or du flipper avec des enjeux bien différents de ceux du passé. Quelle est votre vision de fabricant sur ce sujet?
Let's talk about two things. One is manufacturing, but the other is games. You know, we manufacture games and we have, you know, largest part of the market, and manufacturing can be very difficult. The product has become more and more complicated because the player has become more and more sophisticated. Not just the core player or the people that are at this tournament, but game players in general live with a technological society, and they have game. More complex games, more rules in their games, so forth. Our pinball machines are still easy to learn, hard to master, still have things for players like me that aren't so great, like how I concentrate on how I get my multi-ball. But we have to have the more complex game with the more complex rules and a lot more mechanical toys. So it's complicated. And in today's world with supply chain difficulties, it's very complicated. Yet, we are not just a manufacturer. We manufacture our games. More important, we're designers, and the design of the game and creating the game and the fun of the game and carrying that forward with certainly with merchandise, with accessories, with some digital games, with events like we're at here today. All of this carries it forward. Most important, carrying it forward, is insider connected. It's connecting our pinball machines throughout the world, through the cloud. All products today that are interesting are connected. If my ice maker at home and my refrigerator stops working during this interview, my phone is going to tell me. Now, I don't really care about my ice maker not working, but that's what's going on. Every interesting product, because there's so much more you can do. In our new Bond game, there are features that will be rules and features that can't be done without going to the cloud. So only with the cloud and with the computing capabilities we have can we create the new things. So we will have new levels of gameplay, new techniques for operators and information for operators. And again, it's achievements and merit badges, promotions, so forth. All this is possible. So I see it growing in the cloud and in the game. But the game is still a ball and bat game. It's on the playfield.
Stern brille par la qualité des licences choisies. Avez-vous prévu néanmoins des sorties sans licence grand public avec des thèmes uniques, ou bien est-ce que c'est trop risqué dans le contexte actuel?
We're introducing Bond right now. And I always talk about the games we're making and not the games that we haven't made yet. But we are very, very... This game's incredibly good. George Gomez, our chief creative officer, designed it himself. Not by himself, but led the design of it. He has an encyclopedic knowledge of Bond. James Bond, and it's a passion project for him. Plus we have an extra version, the 60th anniversary limited edition that Keith Elwin, another great pinball designer, designed. So you ask me about the future games, and I'm going to tell you about the game that is the future in a month or a few weeks.
Il y a un an maintenant, vous annonciez le Stern Insider Connected. Depuis, vous investissez beaucoup sur cette nouvelle fonctionnalité. Quelles sont les ambitions de Stern Pinball sur la connectivité?
Insider Connected was loosely, I'm going to say, modeled on Xbox Live, what we saw players, you know, were doing, game players, not pinball players per se, game players. The young people, I'm 77, everybody's a young person. The young people are much more sophisticated and into games and understanding them, and they create a community, not just a pinball community, like we talk about our pinball community, and we have a core of really passionate people, but a community grows bigger when there's connectivity and they can have the greater rewards. There's maybe 300 million subscribers to Xbox Live. We haven't reached 300 million yet. We certainly hope that we will, or get, you know, millions and millions and millions. This will give a lot more aspect to the game, a lot more than just what's on that playfield. It's still ball and bat game, but a lot greater aspect to the game, both with the different things that achievements and different game rules and add-ons and service things. A lot of what happened with Xbox Live came about not as the original plan, but as they saw people using it. We likewise change our plans as we see the usage. We quickly introduced leaderboards, which wasn't planned for way down later in the program, when it was so successful at Pinball Expo and it was so successful at the commercial IAPA show in Orlando. Customers, players wanted that, So we switched gears and we did that. We've recently added a home team where people with the games at home can set up the regular people where they don't have to log in all the time. We've added more aspects and more rules. We've added the ability to put your QR code in a wallet. It's clear that we are developing an app that just takes time, and a lot will come forth with that app somewhere after the first of the year. So, but that's just a little bit. This thing will never be completed because we will learn more and more that consumers want, that operators want, that players want. And as we learn more, we'll change what our plan is, we'll change what we're doing. But I have to say, we're investing a lot of money in this because we believe in it. I believe in it. I believe that if we're not connected, if we're just a standalone game, we're not part of the overall environment of the world today. And we will limit ourselves and we will limit our fun, whether it be for the hobbyist or the casual player. We will limit ourselves if we're not in the technological world of Insider Connected.
Vous avez pris le temps, et on vous en remercie, de venir voir la communauté française du flipper. Quelle est l'importance du marché européen et français en particulier pour Stern Pinball?
We are, you know, we are an American manufacturer. We don't make the games in China, but we export them throughout the world. Western Europe, our export business, in fact, is probably 35-40% of our business. Without that 35-40%, we would suffer greatly. We concentrate on it. Very, very important. Western Europe in particular, and Western Europe even in more particular, is a major part. France historically has always been a large part of the pinball business. I go back to the days of my childhood with Gottlieb being the leading manufacturer for France and so forth. It was, France has always been important. Plus that, I like France. So, you know, I could tell you stories of market research consists of going from one cafe having a glass of wine and playing maybe two glasses of wine, going to another cafe. It's very, market research was great in France. Just go to cafes and play pinball and drink wine. It's good.
Une question maintenant un peu plus personnelle. Quel est votre premier souvenir au sujet du flipper?
You know, I tell you I am told this story, and I don't necessarily remember it, but I used to go to work on Saturdays with my father when I was a small child. You know, he went to work. I went there. And those who've been around know that all the switches used to be leaf switches. And you took different pieces of phosphorus bronze, and they had a contact point in them, and they were staked together to make a switch. And all these little leafs were different metal stampings, and they got very mad at me when I was playing with them all and mixed them all up and, you know, got them all in the factory, in the stock room messed up. I was negotiating with the union once, and the union rep, this was at Williams, which was a union shop, and the union rep got mad. He had started in the stock room, and he said to me, I should have left you in that box and shipped you out that day. You know, because you messed up all of my parts and so forth. So I've been around it for a long time, They've got too many memories, and a lot of them at my age, I can't even remember anymore.
Si vous deviez retenir une machine et une seule, ça serait laquelle et pourquoi?
Bond, James Bond, 007, no question about it. It's a great pinball machine. And yes, it's the game we're making now. It'd be very hard for me to choose one of our games over another because I love all my children. But the one I love the most right now, and it is a great game. It is going to be great. But we've made some wonderful games recently. Godzilla, Mandalorian, just, you know, Rush, We do a lot of, we do very good rock and roll games. We do Marvel once every 2 years, probably. We do Lucas once every 2 years. And these games are just, they're works of love by their designers, and not just the playfield designer, the rules designer, the whole team that works on it. So I love all my children. But today, James Bond 007.
Quelle est votre plus grande fierté dans l'aventure de Stern Pinball?
Greatest pride in the Stern Pinball adventure. I'll go back to your earlier questions. And my greatest pride is that we have been able to keep pinball alive. We think, you know, again, the world would exist without pinball. A little of the fabric of life would be gone. We've been able to provide work for those people. We employ 400 or so people. Plus, there's another 3,000 people in the extended community of suppliers that do some of the work on our games. A lot of people make their livings off it, and a lot more people make a lot of fun off of it. So I'm very, very proud that we're able to continue this, and I'm more proud that we are going to continue pinball.
Dans toute votre carrière, quelle est la question que l'on ne vous a jamais posée et que vous auriez aimé que l'on vous pose?
You know, there's something that I usually ask the opposite of that. You know, I've talked there. You know, what should I have asked you? And now you're asking me, you know, what question I have not been asked. That is very, very hard to answer, because it's pretty much an open book. I don't have a good answer for you.
Merci beaucoup, Gary. Merci infiniment de vous être déplacé ici pour rencontrer la communauté, et merci de nous avoir accordé cette interview exclusive.
Well, thank you for your interest in pinball and being interested enough to interview me. But I will say, it's very nice to interview me. I speak for the hundreds of people that are behind Stern Pinball making this happen. That one question, I'm sitting here thinking, I cannot come up with a question that I should have been asked. I really can't.